Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to this session on Companies Act. So today, what are we going to talk about in the chapter of Companies Act? A lot of you have been asking me to have regular sessions on Companies Act because we all feel that it is very confusing, has a lot of facts and numbers and figures, and therefore becomes confusing at times or becomes difficult to remember. So regular revision becomes important, and that is why I am here. Today, we are going to pick up the chapter of penalties. That is something that has recently been amended or changed, and therefore it becomes very important for your examination. Okay. Before moving on with the entire session, let me take you to the courses for SEBI as well as RBI. And the reason for that is very simple, that a lot of you are probably coming here for the first time and therefore don't know where to go or what kind of courses to take for yourself. When it is about SEBI or RBI examination, you just go to the website anujjindal.in, and there in the buy courses section, you will be taken to the courses that are on offer. You can also take a trial, a 10-day trial, which will help you understand how I teach, how we discuss everything, and how I've covered the entire course for you guys. Okay. We still have more than a month for the examination, and therefore, if you feel that you are weak in a certain area, you can certainly improve in that area in this time span. 1 month, 1.5 months is still enough for us to improve on our weaknesses. What are the courses? There is a complete course for both phase one and phase two, which is for 18,000. You will get a 15% discount using this code. Don't forget to use the code. For legal aspirants, there is an only PDF course, which is in collaboration with Law Digest. And for paper two, there's a separate course, which is for 10,000, and the 15% discount stays there as well. Okay. So this is for SEBI. Now let's talk about the courses on RBI. There is certainly, of course, a 10-day free trial wherein your email ID will be required. And using that email ID, I will be sending you a 10-day free course so that you understand how we teach and what are we going to discuss over the next 6-7 months that we might have for the examination. There is a phase one and phase two complete course, which covers the entire course, whether it's current affairs, whether it's static GK, whether it's quant reasoning English, whether it's phase two finance management, ESI English, everything. Okay. If you feel that you have already prepared for bank exams and therefore you can cover phase one on your own, then you can take this one, which covers the entire phase two plus phase one GA, because phase one GA, both static and the current affairs, holds a high importance, heavy importance in phase one. And therefore, if I'm not helping you prepare for that, I'm not helping you move to the round two, which is phase two as well. Okay. Therefore, phase one is provided in this. And then there are separate courses for phase one only and phase two finance and management, phase two ESI also. Okay. Now let us start with the session. And let me take you through the first question on penalties. If you're coming here for the first time, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel. That gives me the hit to keep making such videos, keep making such courses, which are going to help you in your preparation further. Remember, this is not a live session, and therefore I will be requiring you to write down your answers either on a piece of paper or in the comment section below. The reason is very simple. I want you to know when you are making a mistake so that you can correct them. If you feel that the answer might be B or C, and if you're unable to decide before I tell you the answer, then you are fooling yourself, because you're not actually mocking or creating a mock for yourself before the final examination. It's very important that you take this practice series as a mock series as well. That is only when you will be able to improve. The first question is, according to Companies Act, if the articles are silent on the appointment of first director, subscribers to the memorandum shall be deemed to be the first directors until the directors are duly appointed. So this is an area from where a question can also be asked in the examination. If the articles are silent on appointment of first director, then subscribers to the memorandum will be considered to be the first director. Okay, this can be a question separately. Now the question here is, what is the maximum amount of punishment if such a provision is violated? That is the question. The options are 10,000, 30,000, 50,000, 60,000 and 1 lakh. Let's have the answers. And along with that, I will be explaining you a lot of other things as well. Well, the answer to this question is C, 50,000. That is the penalty if this norm is or provision is violated. Let's come to the explanation, which has a lot of other things to offer as well. If the default continues, a further penalty, which may extend to 500 per day, this is also important. This might also be asked in the examination, during which such default continues shall be charged. If any individual or director of a company makes any default in complying with any of the provisions as per section 152, 155 and 156, so these three things, remember them, these sections are important. If any individual or director of the company makes any default in complying with these provisions as per these sections, such individual or director of the company shall be liable to a penalty which may extend to 50,000 rupees. Okay, that is from where the question was picked up. And where the default is a continuing one with a further penalty which may extend to 500 rupees for each day, this is what is mentioned here. I hope it's clear now. Three things that we have learnt in this question. Let's come to the second question. I want you to write down the answers before I tell you the answer. That's very important. The question is, a company unable to pay dividend to any shareholder after declaration. So the company has already declared that I'm paying you a dividend of, let's say, rupees 1 per share, but I'm unable to pay such dividend to you because of any reason, has to transfer such dividend to an unpaid dividend account. What is the minimum amount of penalty that would be charged from an officer in default of such provision? So if you have not actually transferred that money to unpaid dividend account, then what is the minimum amount of penalty that has to be paid? The options are 10,000, 50,000, 75, 25 and 1 lakh. The answer to this question is D, rupees 25,000. That is the minimum amount of penalty. Please remember this. Let's have a look at the other important aspects of this particular provision as well. In case of any contravention related to unpaid dividend account, the company shall be punished with 1 lakh extendable to 500 by 500 per day, during which such default continues, subject to a maximum of 10 lakh. Remember this, 1 lakh minimum, 500 additional, maximum 1 lakh, 10 lakh, but this is for the company. Every officer in default, the minimum for the officer is 25,000, extendable by 100 per day, maximum of 2 lakh. Now this question talked about the officer and not the company. Okay, that is why the answer to this question is 25,000 and not 1 lakh, the minimum penalty. I hope it's clear now. I'm going a little bit fast, but I'm sure that you can understand where I'm getting at. Okay. Let's come to question number 3. Kevin and Sons is in the business of textile. The business has grown to a large scale over 3 decades. The company plans to get listed in the next 2 years. In the fiscal year 1920, the firm's auditor did not mention the entity's non-compliance with accounting standards in formulating financial statements. Penalties on the auditor. This is another amendment. This was a violation of duty on the part of auditor. What is the penalty he will be liable to pay? Kitni penalty auditor ko deni padegi? Okay, I'll be telling you some additional information as well, so stick around. The answer to this question is B, 1 lakh. 1 lakh is the penalty that the auditor or the cost accountant or the company secretary CS has to pay. Okay, he shall be liable to pay 5 lakh in case of listed company. Now, because the company is not listed yet, that is why the penalty is 1 lakh in case of an unlisted company. Now, what is mentioned in case of removal, resignation or auditor and giving of special notice? Iske mein kya likha hai amendment mein? These are the exact words that have been mentioned. If the auditor does not comply with the provision once he leaves, he shall be liable to a penalty of 50,000 rupees or an amount equal to the remuneration, whichever is less, 50,000 and remuneration, whichever is less. And in case of continuing failure, with a further penalty of 500 rupees for each day after the first during which such failure continues, subject to a maximum of 2 lakh. I hope it's clear. Resignation ke case mein kya bola hai? Agar violate kar raha hai apni duties, if he is violating his duties, then this is the penalty. But if he is resigned but has been unable to provide all the information which was required during resignation, then this is the penalty. Both the penalties are different. I hope it's clear. This is the additional information that I wanted to provide. Next question pe aate hain. Let's come to the next question. Fourth question for today. What is the amount of penalty that will be charged from a person functioning as a director even when he or she knows that the office of such director has become vacant on account of one or more disqualifications. Director has become disqualified, but even then he's not leaving his office or he's discharging his duties, which are illegal, then what is the penalty in this case? Question number 4, and the answer to this question is C, rupees 5 lakh. Let's come to this. According to the amendment made, a person functioning as a director, even when he or she knows that the office of such director has become vacant on account of or disqualification, shall be punishable with a fine of 5 lakh. I hope it's clear. This is all there is to this amendment. Okay. Next question pe aate hain. Question number 5, which says, Miss Kavita is a very experienced business personality. Miss Kavita is a business personality. Due to her shrewd business acumen, she is currently a director of 20 companies. Similar question. One more firm sends her the proposal for the post of director. Unaware of the legal provisions and amendments, Kavita accepts the offer. She doesn't know that she does not qualify to be the director of more than 20 companies. That's another question in front of you. But now she's assumed the charge, and the charge itself is not legal. What is the per day penalty that she would have to pay for such a contravention? Per day penalty kitni hogi? The answer is D, 2000. If a person accepts appointment, ye ek separate provision hai. If a person accepts appointment as a director more than what is allowed, he'll be liable to pay rupees 2000 per day and maximum is 2 lakhs. So that is another question. So teen question yahan se nikal gaye. 2000 per day, 20 companies, and 2 lakh is the maximum penalty. Okay. Sixth question pe aate hain. The question says, a company being a separate legal entity is entitled to hold investments in any security or property on its own name. If a firm tries to circumvent this provision and violates a condition, what amount will it be liable to pay? Separate legal entity, it can hold investments only in its own name. If it violates, what is the penalty that it has to pay? The answer to this question is E, rupees 5 lakh. I have some additional information for you as well. Please remember this as well. In a situation of violation, the company is penalized with 5 lakh. And every officer of the company who is in default, uska kya hai? 50,000. 10%. 5 lakh, 50,000. Okay. Please remember this. Please don't forget this. Very, very important ones. Seventh pe aate hain. Let's come to the seventh question. A company has the power to purchase its own securities, which is known as buyback. Buybacks are related. There were some amendments in the penalties. The sources of money for such a buyback are limited as prescribed. Any non-compliance is dealt with a penalty in relation to buyback. Maximum amount of penalty that the company will have to pay in case of such violation. Maximum amount of penalty that the company has to make. Isme officer ki alag hai, company ki alag hai. Company ki hai 3 lakh. Officer ki dekh lete hain. If a company makes a default in complying with provisions related to buyback, shall be punished with a minimum fine of 1 lakh. Question asked for maximum, which is 3 lakh. Besides, every officer of the company shall be charged with 3 lakh. Ye pehla case hai jahan par, this is the first case where the officer's liability is higher or equivalent to the company's liability. Okay. So please remember this might be asked in the examination as well. So how many questions have we had? We have had 7 questions, and this was all that we had in penalties. Of course, there are some other changes or amendments in the penalties as well, which we will be discussing over a future course of time as and when we have other sessions on this as well. Okay. I hope this session was useful. I hope the penalties were useful. I hope the questions are going to give you a good idea as to what kind of questions can be asked in the examination. Tell you guys all the very best. Take care. Have a nice day.